Okay guys, as you know, back in December of 2019, I purchased this KitchenBoss vacuum sealer because I didn't want to spend the money on getting a FoodSaver brand vacuum sealer. I like this KitchenBoss vacuum sealer. It has been working perfect for me. I like that it's red. You know, it comes in the box. I bought the, it came with the set of 12 or something, different size bags for me to try out. I ended up ordering the six rolls of the two sizes of three rolls each of the cutter boxes, which are no longer available. I purchased the canister set, which a lot of people had questions on. I want to give a shout out to Cat's Cradle, who I first saw this canisters used to seal regular jars. I also ended up buying the Ziploc baggies to try out with this. I think they work just fine. I even bought the FoodSaver portable handheld vacuum sealer with the canister set, the Fresh Saver canister set. I'm not going to review everything in this video. I'll do some other videos on that, but I did want to do a quick review on the KitchenBoss itself and maybe the canister set, because that's what a lot of people had a question on. So here we go. Okay, so the first thing that I'm going to do is I'm going to seal for you this external hard drive in this baggie that I think I've cut myself. I don't remember. Now, a lot of people are complaining sometimes. They don't complain. They make the comment that there seems to be a lot of waste up here when people are doing that. There's a good reason to have that amount of room. First of all, you're not going to get that good of a seal if you try to seal it just a little, you know, try to cut it to the edge. It's just not going to work. I know. I've tried it. You can see a lot of other videos where people have tried it and said the same thing. So just understand that you're going to need some amount of room. There's also a good reason, because if you want to seal something that you want to maybe use for a little bit, like a cheese or a cut of meat that you just want a little bit of, you can always, you know, cut it again, you know, open it up after you've thawed it out, cut it up, put it back in there, and you'll have more room to do seal it and freeze it again if you want to just take a small piece of it. That way you don't have to use another bag or wash the other one out. So what you do is you put it in between the two lines. It's, you know, it's indicated right there with the KitchenBoss. And you know, I've also read that it's good to, if you have a book or something, to put this on. That is true. I've done that. I'm not going to do it here. But you just put it on there with the KitchenBoss. You have to press both sides down. And then you can inch it. So if you're doing something that you don't want to crush, like crackers or something like that, you don't have to, you know, take all the air out. You can inch it. Sometimes I'll even inch the meat as I'm doing it to do it. And it'll stop, and then you vacuum seal, and it will take the air out, and then it will seal. And you heard how loud that it was. It will take a little bit of time because the element is heating up. Right there, it's heating up, it's sealing it. And it's done. So for the KitchenBoss, you press open, it pops open, and there's the seal, and there's the extra room that you have. And it seals great. I have no problem with it. I'll show you some cuts of steak that I've frozen and some chicken. I really like this unit. Okay, so you heard how loud the unit was. It's not very loud. You saw how good it sealed. Here's what I use it for. I will barbecue or grill on the in my cast iron skillet some cuts of meat that I have purchased on sale. What I did first was I had bought these on sale. You know, sometimes you'll find deals at the grocery store where they're trying to make a quick sale because the meat is like a day or two from getting, you know, out of date, and you'll get it for $3 to sometimes $10 less than what the original price is. And what I'll do is I'll come home and I'll either cook it right away, or I'll divide it up, you know, cut the package if there's several pieces in there, and then I'll seal it right away. So these here I've cooked already, and you can see how good it seals. Same thing, these I bought I think they were together and I sliced them and then just made smaller pieces. Here's one that I just recently bought. Real nice thick cut of steak here. I bought some chicken on sale that was about to, you know, that was priced for quick sale. There's the leg. You know, I barbecued it in the grill. Brought it back inside. I did it that afternoon as soon as I came home. Packaged it. This is, I think I have two more packages of this. I've had this frozen for maybe a month, maybe. I think these probably close to a month and a half. I'll be ready to eat these in a couple of days, I think. I also just recently, like just a few days ago, found a good price on these steaks here. These were, I think they're ribeyes. They were 3 to a pack. They were on for quick sale. I came home, froze them. I will say this. When you get your things home or when you cook them, say you cook a couple of steaks and, or you know, 6 or 7 steaks, and you're not going to eat them all, you're going to freeze them for some short-term storage or even long-term storage. You'll see other videos, and I will testify that you'll want to, like when I did these, I had already learned. Once I ate the first one, I took the ones that I was going to vacuum seal, I put them in the freezer and let them freeze for 3 or 4, 6 hours even, so that when you seal them, you don't get the juices that come out. One of these, I think, had the juices. I may not have pulled it out of the freezer, but if you do it when it's, you know, it's warm, you let it thaw out, you let it cool down, but it's not frozen or even refrigerated, your meat or your chicken, you're gonna get juices that try to come up from the vacuum sealer vacuuming it out. So I can testify that it is best if you freeze your cooked and your thawed meats that you want to store first, especially when they're fresh like this, because you'll get the blood that will come out and you will it'll try to come up and you won't get a good seal. You have to have a good seal here. So anyway, this is just a sample of what I have done. You know, I've got my freezer right now full of a bunch of meats like this, along with other frozen stuff that I have that I purchased. You know, I order things also from Omaha Steaks. You know, it's not, you're not going to get a seal like you get from the store or from a place like Omaha Steaks, but it works great. Okay, so I asked KitchenBoss where I could find something that was similar to FoodSaver, that was compatible with their KitchenBoss unit. They directed me to this 3-canister set that is a FoodSaver canister set. However, it is no longer sold in the United States. I went to Amazon because that was the link that they sent me. And don't be fooled, because the price says that it is $25, $25.74 or something like that. I put it in my cart, and when I started to check out, I noticed that the total price was almost $60. So I thought, that's strange. So I went back, and it's because it is no longer sold in the United States, these are shipping now from the UK. So you're paying international charges for it to be shipped. It's coming from global Amazon from the UK. So that's why they cost so much. Now, once again, shout outs to the YouTube channel, Cat's Cradle. It's an old channel. I don't even know if she's active anymore. But this is why I first saw the tip years ago when I was looking at vacuum sealers before I decided to get the KitchenBoss. I had been looking at vacuum sealers for a number of years before I decided to buy one. She had the canister set because that's what it came with, and she figured out that these jars with the push buttons on them, you know, when you open them up, you see the button pop up and you hear the seal break. You could put them in here, in these canisters that they would fit. You could lightly put the lid back on. You could put the hose on and the FoodSaver vacuum sealer, and when it changed, when the sound changed, you knew that you had sucked the air out of the jar and it was ready to seal. When you pushed the button to release the air, you could hear it pop in. And then when you pull it out, what I recommended you start to do this is that because you're only putting the resealable lid on, or the rubber gasket sealed lid on, you don't want to put it on tight like you normally would, like when, after you use it and you're going to store it. You want to put it on just a little bit lightly because you want to have some space in here, just a tiny bit for that vacuum to get in here, and it will cause the lid to vacuum down. And then when you release it, it will pull the button down, and then you just have just a tiny bit to tighten it up to keep it sealed up. With the vacuum food sealer, the FoodSaver units, they have a protrusion that the one in both of their hoses for the FoodSaver have the nipple on them that you stick in. The FoodSaver has one for your lid if you're going to order another type of lid. Like, say I got this FoodSaver, FreshSaver attachment. But the other end where you put the hose in to the vacuuming unit on the KitchenBoss, it has a nipple that comes out, and that's where this goes in. And as you can see, there's only one of the spaces has a hole for the hose. This other one just is to seal it up. So that's the difference. You cannot use this hose with a vacuum FoodSaver vacuum sealer because the tips are different. The way that you insert it in the sealer is going to be different than the KitchenBoss, because the KitchenBoss has a nipple coming out that you plug, that you stick this onto. Now, when you're doing this, I believe the FoodSaver, just based on what I'm seeing, is they kind of snap in. The KitchenBoss doesn't. So if you're doing something like this, if you decide to order this, I ordered this, I know it was expensive. I wanted you guys to see this because I know there were a lot of questions. I ordered this, I knew that I was going to be getting a gift card for $100 or so at some point. I usually get a couple of them for Christmas. I got one, so that's what I spent my gift card money on, was to get this set so I could use it. And it works really, really good with this. Check this out. Man, that's how good it seals. Hear that? This one, each jar will be different. This one took quite a bit in here. It just would not, I would hear it pop down. As soon as I removed the hose, I could hear the air release. So each jar will work differently. Some you'll have immediate success with. Some you will not have any success with it at all. You'll just have to forget about it. And some of you struggle with it a little bit, it will work. I finally got this basil pesto sauce jar to work by using a regular mason jar in this canister, and it finally sealed. For mason jars, it works fantastic, these canisters. You know, you can also get the FoodSaver lids. They have the large lid and the small lid. I may do that at some point. I don't know. I didn't know how much I wanted to do. I'm doing a lot of this mainly to review the KitchenBoss set and how it works. I only really wanted it to do the sealable bags. So, also, just as a note, I sealed this using the canister set at 6:30 p.m. on 4/24, and it's still sealed. The best success that I have had has been with tostitos and on the border hot sauce jars. They work the best. 6:20 p.m. Anyway, it's real tight. It works out real good. This pickle jar, plastic pickle jar, I was able to fit it in the large container, and I did it just today. You can see that the push button, vacuum seal button is down. And you can see that. So the KitchenBoss works really good, whether you're doing it by itself, with just the bags, or whether you're using the canister set. Once again, I'm very happy with it. It's a little bit different than the FoodSaver, but for the price, you know, some of you may say, man, I may as well get a FoodSaver. And you might as well get a FoodSaver. I don't know. Like I said, I'm reviewing a lot of this because people will have questions. People have had questions. But once again, the KitchenBoss by itself, just with the vacuum sealing bags, I have been very happy with. Okay, so like I said, I purchased these ZipLock vacuum sealer bags. I got these at Walmart. You can probably get them anywhere. How much cheaper they were, I don't know. I believe that they were cheaper. A lot of people say that they are. I thought I'd try them out. I was running out of the bags that came with my vacuum sealer, my KitchenBoss vacuum sealer, and I didn't want to cut any bags from the rolls that I had bought. I have plenty left. I'm about to run short on my smaller bags. My larger bags, I still have plenty of. So, and I got this size. This is the quart bags, because I did find myself getting larger cuts of meat. You know, if I wanted to put a good sized chicken breast in here, like I said, you do want to leave room up here. I know it seems like a waste. You're going to end up wasting more if you try to economize on the size of the bag you initially cut, because you're going to end up throwing it away because you're not going to get a good seal. I know that. So with the Ziploc baggie, I'm going to seal it. Seal this Samsung ThinkPad. I'm just going to get a vacuum seal. It's done sucking the air out. Now it's going to seal it. One thing I will say, if you have a whole lot of sealing to do, whether you're just inching or vacuum sealing, you can't do a whole lot in a row. The heating element will get hot. Also, when you open it, if you have any children around, you don't want them touching the heating element. It is hot. It's hot enough to seal this. And that's how good it is. And with these, you can put what you have, the date that you sealed it. Once again, KitchenBoss comes through real good. Now, for the FoodSaver Fresh Saver, I bought the containers. I really do like these. I find them handy. I did find that one of them had released the air before I was ready to let the air out. When I took it out of the refrigerator, the button, the air had already released. I was okay with that. That's why I pulled it out. There's a lot of complaints that these don't seal real good. They lose their seal. FoodSaver does reply that says you do have to make sure that all of this is clean. I thought mine was, and then you also have to make sure that you are pushing it down to get a good seal. Here's the difference between the FoodSaver vacuum sealer and the connection and the KitchenBoss. Like I had said earlier, I believe all the FoodSaver brands, you know, this has the tip here for this adapter, and it doesn't snap in, so you may have to hold it in, you know. And here it doesn't snap in, you may have to hold it in. And I believe the FoodSaver brands, they both have the insert where you put the nipple in on both ends. This one has a nipple on the KitchenBoss that this will fit into. So put this on, and because you cannot press the button and let it run, and you'll see the identification button, I guess they call it. You'll see it go down. So what you have to do is get to your inch button and run the unit. And so you'll see that the button didn't go down. It usually will go down right away. Now, maybe because I didn't press this down all the way, maybe because this seems like it came up a little bit. Sometimes, one time I even taped this. This hose stays twisted. One time I even taped this together using some electrical tape. This hose seems to stay twisted, so it's kind of weird. Sometimes you won't get a good seal because this doesn't snap in. And I don't know if you can see, but that went down. You'll hear the difference in the air pressure. I usually let it run for a little bit longer. No, I have not burned the motor up yet. I'm letting it run so you can hear how loud it is. And that's it. With these, it's best to take the hose off first and then take the attachment off. And there you go. I did also purchase the little rest pads here. It works. It does work great with things that you want to keep off the bottom, like strawberries. I had strawberries for almost a week and 2 days, which is usually good. They were on sale. I got some big, nice, juicy strawberries, 2-for-1. You know, it took me 2 days to eat one container, which was eating a lot of strawberries because they were big. And it took me 3 or 4 days before I got hungry for the other ones. So I was able to put them in here. I didn't slice them up. I just put them in here. Was able to keep them fresh for 4 or 5 days. They came out like the day I bought them at the store. They do say, you know, not to fill up over the line. There are different sizes. It comes in a set. There are two of these and a taller one. And then I also got the large tray. It works really good for like when I want to do a big salad. So that works really good. And then to release it, you just press the button. And you'll hear it and you'll see that come up. Now, I purchased the handheld. It's not as powerful. It is quieter. There it went down. So it takes a little bit longer. They say it will operate off of a charge, a full charge. This takes quite a while. I believe it takes a good 24 hours. I forgot what the instructions said, but they say that this unit is good for 96 uses before you have to reseal it. I have not used it 96 times. I tend to keep the charger plugged in. Not always, because I have other things that I need charged, so I unplug it. But, you know, I'll keep this handy sometimes. I'll use it 6 or 7 times, and then I'll put it back on the charger. But this, I do like these. A lot of people complain, once again, they also complain about the canisters, is that, oh, I dropped it and it cracked. It's really bad quality. Guys, they're hard plastic. Don't drop them. Hard plastic breaks if you drop them on the floor from a pretty good distance. That should be known. Okay, I purchased these FoodSaver. I think I got these from FoodSaver, I don't remember. These fresh saver bags for things that you don't want to freeze. You just want to put in the refrigerator for keeping it a little bit longer. Say cold cuts, you know, things like that, that, you know, if you put them in, wrap it back up in the package that you originally bought it in. If you don't, you know, eat it right away, they get dry around the edges, cheese, things like that. two of these I ended up not being happy with. These are just okay. I silt this a couple of hours ago, and I can feel this losing a little bit of air already. The first time I did it in here, it lasted about a week before the air was released. The first time that I used these bags, I believe they came three in the package, they worked fine. I sealed some stuff up, put it in the refrigerator. I forgot what it was. Kept them in there for, you know, 2 or 3 weeks. I think I made some cookies and put them in here. And kept them in my cupboard for, you know, 2 or 3 weeks, and they came out and they were soft. But I sealed it up again later. I sealed something up again. This, it could be because I reused it. They say you can wash them and reuse them. This one was pretty successful. This one was not as successful. In fact, you don't even need the attachment for this. You'll see that the air comes out. But I already know with this one, because I've tried it over and over and over, the air will come out in about 10 to 15 minutes, if not sooner. I've looked at it, I put water in it, tried to see if there was a leak. There isn't. I think it's because maybe when I was washing it, these little partial sealer vacuum plastic attachment thingies, I think maybe I kind of pulled one apart a little bit from the plastic itself. I think that's why, I don't know. These are just okay. They're not the greatest. I would go with either these, or I would suggest if you're doing cold cuts, or if you're doing cheese, something that you're, you know, like me, I live by myself. I don't eat cheese anyway, but if I had a block of cheese and or slices of cheese and it was going to take me a week, you know, 9 days to eat it, if I try to even put it back in its little sealable bags, they do tend to dry out around the edges. This is what I used one of these for at first. It worked really good, but because I'm really uncertain about those bags now, I would just seal it in a bag with the vacuum sealer, put it in the refrigerator, because you're not going to freeze cold cuts or blocks of cheese or anything like that. Leave enough room so that when you decide to pull it out of the refrigerator and pull a couple of slices or a couple of slices of cheese out of it, or grate it or whatever, you have enough room. You know, you have enough room when you sealed it. Say the block of cheese is down here. You have a big piece of plastic. You cut it, you pull the cheese out, you slice what you need, you grate what you need, cold cuts, whatever, and you have plenty of room to seal more, and you can use it over and over and over. And when you're finally through, you can just toss the bag away. Now, having said that, you will save a little bit of money if you wash the bags, because they're washable. And if you have enough room after you've cut them or used them, whatever, if you wash them and let them dry. I find that to be kind of a headache after I tried it. I would rather just cut the bag and dispose of it. That's one of the reasons that we bought this unit for, and that's why we're doing this. Sometimes we get low on money and we want to do that. That's perfectly fine. But just know that it gets to be a little bit of a hassle to be doing that. So for the most part, I choose to use the bags. When I'm through with them, I will just dispose of them, and I have no problem doing that. So the KitchenBoss vacuum sealer, model G200 in red, with some FoodSaver accessories, some ZipLock vacuum seal bags, quart bags, and some samples of what I have used it for. Thank you for coming back and watching this review. Thanks for the thumbs up.